In what police are calling one of the largest seizures of stolen goods in the history of New York City, thieves inexplicably led police to a treasure trove of stolen cars, furs, paintings.
Louis Booker, you degenerate moron. Were these medieval times and you a knight in shining armor? You would, I have no doubt, slay the maiden and save the dragon.
Sal, if we could explain.
As for you, Charlie, after the tragic death of your father, I married your mother, promising her that I would raise you as my own. You chose not to take the Maggio name. I did not complain. And when you had to go to beauty school, those boys who lose their fathers early in life often do. I did not snivel at your intentions, did I?
No, Salvatore, you did not. In fact,
I bought a beauty pommel so that you could sit on your lazy butt all day. $4.5 million you cost me. Were you anybody else? You'd be dead by now.
Sal, we understand that you're upset.
It's not your fault.
What?
A lion can raise a mouse. A mouse is still a mouse. And you, Charlie, are that mouse. Look at this. It takes it. Chicken blood.
Excuse me, Sal. You said that he was a mouse, so that would be mouse blood. Not chicken blood, right? Go on, Sally. Here if you need me.
The salient point is, I must continue to live with my lovely wife, and tears on her pillow are a plethora to me, anathema to me. You see what they got me doing? I can't even talk straight.
Take it easy, Sal.
So, I'm giving you both another chance to redeem yourselves.
Thank you, Sal. We won't disappoint you.
But no, we won't.
Sure. Frankie.
Hey, kid. Go along.
Did you pull the boys in? The mission of absolution.
It's simple. You take this envelope to JFK Airport.
No problem.
You catch tonight's flight for Sydney, Australia.
Wow, that's, you know, Lewis has got this thing.
Yeah, see, because my mama, she got the gout, and if I'm not home to rub her feet, you know, her ankles just swell up, and she can't take her house shoes off.
Yeah, this, you know, this really isn't much warning.
Need a warning?
No.
From Sydney, you take the old South Road due north to a place called Coober Pedy, where you meet a man named Mr. Smith. You give this envelope to Mr. Smith. Mr. Smith is expecting you no later than noon local time. You will not be late.
What's in here, man?
Do not look in that envelope under any circumstances. Understood?
I can hear you.
Understood!
Oh, yeah.
Should you run into any problems, you can reach Mr. Smith at this phone number.
Get out of here. I can't believe all that stuff happened, man. I'm wearing my lucky jacket.
Lucky jacket? Lewis, you've been wearing that jacket for over 10 years, and I've never seen luck even remotely come near you.
Australia. And then they're just gonna turn around and come right back again.
It won't be so bad.
Why not?
We're canceling.